If you guys have been on the channel long enough, you guys know I usually go caseless with my iPhone 15 Pro for me personally. Sometimes, you know, I do caseries and stuff like that. I test out cases and stuff like that. And I do use a case for like a week at a time, 2 weeks at a time, just to test out the case and to just show you guys case reviews, because I know you guys like case reviews. But for the most time that I had the phone, I use it caseless and also screen protectorless as well. So the reason for that is because I really just don't like to add cases and extra bulk on my phone, just because I like the natural feeling of the iPhone 15 Pro, because it feels so good in my hand, especially with the new kind of curved design and the titanium material. It just feels super, super nice in my hand. And I really don't like to add a case to it because it kind of just ruins the feeling and it just ruins the feeling of the phone in my hand. I just don't like that. So for me personally, it's worth it to go caseless, and I pretty much do this every single year. And so with this year, the iPhone 15 Pro model is a titanium frame, like I said previously. So this is something different, and they did that for a lot of reasons. One is to make it more durable and less prone to scratches, because it is a matte kind of, you know, texture now, not a glossy kind of mirror texture anymore. So with this, it does prevent, you know, scratches and stuff like that with getting on the phone, which I do really, really like. That is a huge plus to the titanium frame on this phone, because I have noticed with previous stainless steel model iPhones, it gets super, super scratched. Every single time, pretty much at the 6 month mark, my phone looks absolutely destroyed. It's so scratched because, like I said, I use my phone caseless for most of the time. And so with this titanium model, it looks a lot and a lot better, but there are still some bruises and blemishes on the phone, just because I use it on, you know, with caseless day to day. But first I want to show you guys this charger that I've been using, the ESR 3-in-1 charger. So for this right here, I've been looking for a 3-in-1 charger for a long time now. And one thing that I really do like about this one specifically is that how it's built, I can use it in the landscape mode. So basically I have the standby mode right here, and that's very, very clutch, especially for like a bedside table or to put on a desk or something like that, because it just looks so clean with the clock and everything like that. And it just looks so good. With some chargers, this, you know, the Apple charger is kind of in the way, so you can't really move it in this landscape portrait. So I really do like that they made it where you can have it landscape, and so you can use a standby feature, which is a very important feature with the new iOS update. So it also has Qi2 15 watt charging, so basically it charges just as fast as like Apple's MagSafe charger, so you don't have to worry about like low speeds or anything like that charging your iPhone or other Apple tech with this charger, which you want to make sure it has the same exact technology that is used in the Apple accessory. So if you guys are interested in checking out ESR, I'll leave a link down in the description below where you guys can check them out. So first things first, guys, we're going to check out the sides of the iPhone 15 Pro. So like I said previously, the sides are significantly better than the previous models that I've had, the previous Pro model, just because of the titanium frame on this phone. It just makes it way more durable. First side right here is the power button sign. And as you guys can see right here, I don't see any, okay, I see like one little scratch on the actual power button, but other than that, I don't see any other scratches on this specific side right here. And then we're gonna go to the top of the phone. As you guys can see right here, the top of the phone does have one little scratch on the top. I don't know how this came up. I don't know where the scratch came from, but there is a scratch right here. I tried to like scratch it off with my fingernail just to see if it was like a dirt mark or anything like that. It's not, it's actually on the titanium frame, which honestly, one little scratch on the top, not really a big deal at all. It's barely even noticeable. There are some little dings and stuff like that, but that's like the main scratch right there that's on the top. And then we're gonna go on the volume button side. As you guys can see, basically looks exactly the same as the power button side. No really visible scratches that I can see, at least in this lighting right here. And then we're gonna go on the charge port side, which this is very, very impressive. So as you guys can see, there is like one visible scratch that I can see with my eye, but that is not bad at all, because I used to charge this phone for the majority of life before I got this charger. I used to charge it with just the USB-C, and obviously with that, I accidentally missed the USB charge port and actually hit like the border of the phone. And I used to do that a lot with my previous phones, and it was super scratched on the charge port side. But with this titanium frame, dude, it's not, it's barely scratched. Like there's only one scratch. It's not even near the USB-C charge port. So, all right. So the next side we're gonna be looking at is the back of the phone, the glass portion of the phone. So right here, honestly, I didn't notice anything at first, but when I looked at this to make this video, I was just like, is there any scratches on there? And there actually is some wear and tear on the back glass of this phone right here. So as you guys know, the camera, the camera area pops out like crazy. So basically when you put it on a table, it lands on these two edges, obviously the camera edge and this corner right here, just because of how, you know, the cameras lay on the table. So in this corner, I do see some wear. Obviously it's not really noticeable like at all. I literally had to look at it for this video to actually notice it, but there is some wear on the glass. It's like more of a glossy kind of, it's like turning glossy versus, you know, obviously this is matte. So it's like having some wear on this specific corner. It's honestly not bad at all though. And then I'm gonna take a look at the cameras really quick as well. There's no scratches at all. I do see a nick in the plastic of the camera, but not the actual glass of the camera right there. And that's obviously normal because it is hitting that camera every time you lay it down. So I do see a little nick. I didn't even notice it until filming this video. So it's not bad at all. So the next thing is the screen. So this is probably, this is definitely where the most damage is. Obviously the glass is the most, you know, easy to scratch part of the phone. And that's the most used part of the phone as well. So as you guys can see, there are scratches pretty much everywhere. It's not like the worst scratched phone that I've ever seen, but there are some definite visible scratches on the phone. And whenever I put a screen protector on the phone, I do see like air bubbles where the scratches are. So basically if I put a screen protector on it, there's just pretty much a permanent mark where the scratch is. And it just reminds me that my phone is scratched when I put a screen protector on it. When there's no screen protector on it, I don't really notice them too much unless it's in specific lighting. But again, when I put a screen protector on it, you can see them very, very easily. So I'm really, really happy again that they changed to titanium, because my phone actually looks pretty decently new versus my iPhone 14 Pro when I sold it. It had a lot of scratches on it and it just did not look good. But this year, it looks a lot better. And I kind of heard some rumors that they might be changing this titanium to be a more kind of glossy look like on the previous models, which I wouldn't really be a big fan of because it would just scratch again and it just wouldn't look good. So I really do like this kind of matte texture, titanium texture on this iPhone 15 Pro series. It just way better in my personal opinion. It might not look as like classy as like a glossy stainless steel border iPhone, but it still looks really, really good in my personal opinion. And over time, it will look a lot better as well, as you guys can see right here. So again, shout out to ESR for sponsoring this video. If you guys wanna check out this 3-in-1 charger, which I highly recommend, I'll leave it in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.